almost always at the hands of liberal mayors or governors. Again, state representatives, state houses, where are you? Now, the latest case comes out of Kentucky. That's a Republican state legislature, by the way, where state troopers, acting on the orders of Democrat Governor Andy Beshear, wrote down the license plate numbers of Easter worshipers at Maryville Baptist Church. Now, the troopers left notices on churchgoers' windshields threatening further enforcement if they didn't self-quarantine for 14 days. Pastor Jack Roberts also said piles of nails, and there are pictures of them on Twitter, had been dumped at the entrances to the church parking lot. They were picked up by parishioners, and they went in anyway. Joining me now, Harmeet Dhillon, civil rights attorney and Trump 2020 campaign advisory board member. Harmeet, the constitutional rights that we all hold dear, they can be intruded upon, infringed upon, in very limited circumstances, as the attorney general told me last week. Am I missing something here, or are we down a really slippery slope of infringement?
Well, Laura, you're absolutely correct. And, you know, as they said in Animal Farm, some animals are more equal than others. So in this case, many governors, including California, immediately issued exemptions for the First Amendment for reporters who are allowed to do their jobs freely, but clamped down on religion. And this has happened all over the country. And so what the Attorney General was talking about was a Supreme Court case that says that religion may be treated as equally as any other organization, and that is not discriminatory. But here, where every governor and every county in the country has exemptions for different professions, for alcohol stores, for pot stores, for grocery stores, for even abortion facilities in some states. So there are a lot of exemptions, but those exemptions are not being allowed to religion, so that's unequal.
Yeah, well, Governor Beshear has state troopers harass the celebrants. That came after a federal judge castigated the mayor of Louisville for what the mayor of Louisville was doing, right? They were, you know, same kind of deal there. But he wrote, and this judge is also up for a D.C. Circuit nomination. He was nominated by the president a couple weeks ago. He said, on Holy Thursday, an American mayor criminalized the communal celebration of Easter. That sentence is one that this court never expected to see outside the pages of a dystopian novel, or perhaps the pages of The Onion. The mayor's decision is stunning, and it is, beyond all reason, unconstitutional. Harmeet, what was the judge getting at there? And clearly, success on the merits. This is just a temporary restraining order, but these are legal battles that have to be waged now against these lockdowns and at least the attacks on religion.
Well, some of us have been saying that from the beginning, Laura, but what the judge was saying right there is that it is unconstitutional to pick on people of faith. And by the way, it's also unconstitutional to quarantine people who aren't sick or who haven't been exposed to an illness. And in that state, they actually have a Religious Freedom Restoration Act, which provides a higher level of protection than the Constitution of the United States. So that's doubly bad for those folks. And in my law firm and Center for American Liberty just filed a lawsuit in San Bernardino and Riverside counties today on the same issue, that the police and the counties are picking on people of faith and are harassing them, issuing tickets to them. Soup kitchens are being shut down if they're run by religious institutions, but not if they're run by the government. So this is blatant persecution of people of faith and organizations, and we have to fight back on it now. It doesn't matter if it's only 2 more weeks or 4 more weeks. There should not be a minute of our liberty infringed.
Well, Harmeet, this is precedent setting. We're going to track this every night because this could set precedents if we don't see these kinds of constant challenges. I know you're waging a good fight in California, but this decision by Judge Walker was phenomenal. It was blistering. And I hope these Republican state legislators are paying attention to this because all of them are like not at work. I don't understand how people are not working when they're supposed to be looking out